The year is 1796. Imagine an English countryside where a curious physician named Edward Jenner is observing a peculiar phenomenon. He notices that milkmaids, often exposed to cowpox, rarely fall victim to the deadly smallpox. Intrigued, he takes a bold step. Using material from a cowpox sore, he inoculates a child. Against all odds, that child becomes immune to smallpox. This moment marks the birth of the first vaccine, a discovery that would go on to save millions of lives. Fast forward to today, vaccines have evolved from protecting against smallpox to combating rabies, polio, and even eradicating diseases like smallpox altogether. Most recently, during the COVID-19 pandemic, we witnessed a groundbreaking leap, the mRNA vaccine. This new technology enabled the creation of vaccines in record time, just 11 months, ushering in a new era of rapid adaptable disease response. Yet, despite their promise, mRNA vaccines face daunting challenges. Distribution gaps, high production costs, complex cold chain requirements, and issues with tolerability have created barriers to equitable access, both around the globe, but even here in Georgia. Let's explore why these challenges exist and how they can be overcome. But first, here's a quick high school biology refresher. DNA serves as the instruction manual for life, RNA acts as a messenger to communicate DNA's instructions, and proteins are the end output. Messenger RNA vaccines, or mRNA vaccines, use this principle. They deliver a snippet of genetic code that instructs cells to produce a small piece of a virus, triggering the immune system to defend against it. By changing these snippets, we can target different viruses and design new vaccines. Simple in concept, right? Well, not quite. The body's defenses do not make it easy for mRNA to reach its intended target, the inside of a cell. And for mRNA vaccines, this challenge is even bigger, because not only does mRNA need to get inside a cell, but it needs to get inside the right immune cells to defend against viruses. To overcome this, scientists spent over 50 years developing lipid nanoparticles, tiny bubbles of fat that shield the mRNA and get it into the right cells. Now, while they're effective, these nanoparticles come with many challenges. They're expensive, difficult to manufacture, cause acute side effects, and are temperature sensitive. This brings us to our breakthrough, rooted in a unique discovery that a barbecue lighter, the same kind of lighter you'd use to ignite your grill, can deliver mRNA into cells. When you click a lighter, it produces a brief electric pulse using piezoelectricity. We discovered that same pulse can open a door to a cell, allowing mRNA and other molecules to pass through. Within seconds, that door closes, allowing the cell to translate mRNA's message into a vaccine. Enter Piezopen, a device inspired by a lighter that harnesses piezoelectricity along with a microarray patch to deliver mRNA vaccines directly into the immune cells of your skin without the need for lipid nanoparticles or even a syringe needle. To demonstrate, I simply take the device and I attach a tip containing the vaccine. Once assembled, I press it against my skin and I click the button. When I'm done, I throw this tip away and I keep the rest of this device to reuse. Consider the significance of what I'm showing you here. With this simple device, we could reduce the costs of each mRNA vaccine dose by over 50%, improve their temperature stability, and administer vaccines ourselves. Piezopen could allow you to put the power of vaccination into your own hands. Let's unpack what this means in more detail. To achieve global scalability and low cost, we leverage existing manufacturing techniques used to produce lighters. Over 20 billion lighters are produced every year, with one company making 6 million of them every single day. By tapping into this, we've reduced costs to under $1 per device. And because it's based on a lighter, it requires no power source and is small enough to fit into your pocket. Lighters are also designed to withstand harsh conditions, operating at both sub-zero temperatures and extreme heat, making them robust and durable for use anywhere in the world. In much of the world, this is what refrigerated transport of vaccines looks like. This is a big challenge in my home country of India, where almost 1 billion people live in rural areas. Growing up there and seeing this subpar infrastructure firsthand has played a significant role in my inspiration to solve this challenge. For Piezopen, we can leverage advances in microarray patch technology to dry vaccines onto these small tips. This allows us to eliminate cold chain dependency, enabling room temperature storage and transportation to the last mile. While the COVID-19 vaccines have been proven to be safe in over 1 billion people, there still remain concerns with tolerability and side effects driven by lipid nanoparticles. These tolerability concerns can hinder broader uptake of vaccines, but also limits how much mRNA we can deliver. By removing lipid nanoparticles, we improve tolerability and reduce side effects while also enabling higher dose or multi-target vaccines. For example, we could combine COVID, flu, and RSV vaccines into a single shot. Right? Lastly, getting a vaccine today requires you to go into a clinic and have a nurse or a physician administer a shot. This requires a significant amount of training and can hinder uptake in regions where there may only be a few providers. Piezopen, on the other hand, requires minimal training, and anyone, including patients themselves, could administer a vaccine, paving the way for broader coverage. Now, while this technology solves many challenges with mRNA vaccines, it could also revolutionize vaccination as we know it. Imagine a world where, during an outbreak, devices are pre-stocked worldwide, ready to deliver life-saving vaccines at a moment's notice. Or soldiers in remote combat zones can be vaccinated rapidly without needing power or refrigeration, even in austere environments. And in rural villages, where 1 in 5 children currently miss out on basic immunizations, healthcare workers can get to that last mile with affordable and portable devices, ensuring that no child is left behind. Piezopen transforms not just vaccination, but the very way we think about global health. It bridges the gap between innovation and accessibility, turning a household item used by billions every day from around the world, from Antarctica to the Sahara Desert, into a tool for resilience and hope. This technology could unlock a new future for mRNA vaccines while slashing costs, increasing access, and strengthening global health. Edward Jenner once said, "I hope that someday the practice of producing cowpox in human beings will spread all over the world. And when that day comes, there will be no more smallpox." Today, with the power of this technology, we have the opportunity to realize this vision, not just against smallpox, but against every disease, known and unknown, to protect future generations. Thank you.